The top Philippine intelligence official grilled over sharing supposedly fake news on social media, including red-baiting progressive groups and individuals. Lawmakers from the so-called Makabayan Bloc raised the issue during last week's hearings on the proposed budget of the National Intelligence Coordinating Agency, or NICA. But the agency's Director General Alex Paul Monteagudo says he was merely sharing intelligence information with his personnel. He also claims he does not know the people behind the Facebook pages he's been sharing posts from. Joining us now is Kabataan Party's Representative Sara Ilago. Congresswoman Ilago has been the subject of many of these red-baiting posts online. Good morning, Congresswoman Ilago, and thank you very much for joining us.
Hi, good morning, Christian, and to all our viewers.
How do you respond to that explanation given by Director General Monteagudo? That part of his argument was that this is part of freedom of expression of those who were making those posts and that he was just sharing them.
Christian, it's not okay to be sharing disinformation and false viral claims, especially coming from the head of the premier intelligence agency of the government. We asked him during the floor deliberations of the agency, and he didn't even know, you know, the authors, the administrators of the said Facebook pages, which have records, you know, of sharing false viral claims against this representation.
Mm. In your case, what was the worst, or what were the worst posts or fake news spread about you and against you on social media coming from these accounts linked to the police or the military?
First is the terrorist tagging, because with the anti-terror law now in effect, you can be arrested, you can be detained based on mere suspicion up to 24 days maximum. And this has an effect not only on this representation, but to our membership. It puts our membership, our constituents, the youth and students, in peril at the immediate threat of being detained, or worse, extrajudicial killings, especially now that we're in the midst of a situation of worsening the human rights conditions and persistent impunity in the country.
Because if you ask them, they're just looking at this. Part of the argument that they're using is that this is a propaganda war, and they're countering the propaganda coming from the left, including yourself. According to them, they're just trying to set the record straight. Of course, some other information are being added into the mix. How do you respond to that?
On the part of this youth representation, we've been targeted as the representative of youth and students, because historically, and we can see at present how the young people, the students, are vocal and critical about the present administration's policies. And targeting their representation in Congress is just part of a broader attempt to silence critical independent voices, suppress dissent, and consolidate more unchecked power.
Now, just to be clear, you are crying foul over specifically, for example, the fact that you're being tagged as a terrorist, because that would, of course, that could endanger your life and, of course, the safety and security of those around you. But how about criticism, even how vicious they are? Are you okay with this? I'm looking at some of the posts that were made against you. I don't have to read many of them, but basically, you're being described as a virus in that you're trying to dupe the youth, complete with pictures, etc., etc. I mean, can this be seen as under the as part of artistic or even a freedom of expression?
Christian, these are false viral claims that has not only have hypothetical threat, but it's a real threat to activists, to all who want to exercise their political and civil rights to speak up. Hindi dapat natin tanggapin, and we should not accept this as part of the normal, lalong-lalo na nanggaling sa intelligence chief, ang hindi dependable at reliable naman na information. Dahil dun sa laki ng kanilang impluensya, hindi dapat pinagamit yung posisyon para magkalat ng maling impormasyon.
Now, give us an idea of how bad the situation is in terms of the spread of false information or vicious information against you, for example. One part of the statement issued by the Director General of NICA, Mr. Alex Monteagudo, read that the Makabayan Bloc is masquerading as defenders of human rights when they are actually part of a terrorist organization that has killed thousands of Filipinos. And I know that you're being linked directly as part of the Communist Party of the Philippines or even the New People's Army. So how bad is the situation so far, and how are you countering them?
Well, first, no, that's not true. No, hindi po totoo, no, yung mga walang batayan na mga allegasyon na yan. And these attempts, no, to arbitrarily and desperately link us, no, to armed rebel groups, no, these incites more hate and harm and encourages further attacks against this representation. At hindi po katanggap-tanggap yun, no, dahil ina-atake yung mandato ng mga duly elected officials, lalong-lalo na sa amin, no, bilang party's representative na may responsibilidad na magbigay ng boses doon sa hindi pa natin gaanong narinig sa ating lipunan.
Okay, I'll give you the opportunity to explain the difference here, because I think based on what I've been reading on social media, a lot of people are getting confused that just because, for example, your ideology leans toward the left, you're being automatically tagged as part of the New People's Army or the Communist Party of the Philippines, and that you're automatically out there espousing the idea of raising arms against the government. Talk to us about the difference between an activist espousing leftist leanings, for example, and those who are actually out to overthrow the government through armed means.
Activism, you know, it's a speaking up, no, taking action to advance a meaningful and positive change in our communities. Pwede sa school, no, pwede sa iyong barangay, maski nga sa loob ng tahanan, eh, pwede ka na magsalita, no, tungkol sa nais mong mapabuti at mapaunlad ng mga bagay. Iba na nausapin, no, pag doon na sa pag-overthrow ng government, kasi yun naman ay may mga karampatan ng mga parusa, no, sa ilalim ng ating mga batas. Ang dangerous dito, yung kapag pinapag-ugnay mo, no, yung dalawa, dahil yan ay may malaking chilling effect. No? It affects the capacity of young people to ask questions, express their views, engage people in power, and participate in nation building. No? Kaya hindi namin pinapalagpas, no, itong mga red tagging, no, terror tagging na naglalagay sa panganib, no, sa buhay ng napakaraming mga kabataan na gusto lamang gawin ang lahat, no, para magkaroon ng mas magandang kinabukasan at mas magandang kasalukuyan, no, sa ating bayan.
Okay, now a piece of good news that actually favored you and the others who are being red-baited was the fact that Facebook decided to take down more than 100 fake Facebook accounts and pages, many of them linked to the Philippine military and the police. But yesterday, Interior Secretary Eduardo Anyo appealed to Facebook. He wanted a dialogue because according to him, there has to be a sense of fairness by Facebook. And of course, I think the argument from the security forces is, again, this many of these pages are part of the advocacy of the government to counter the propaganda coming from the left. In your case, first, let's talk about the action of Facebook. Do you think that's enough?
Christian, there's more to be done. No? Ang dami pang dapat gawin dahil sobrang dami pa rin ng mga lumalabas na mga fabricated statements at mga fake accounts na vilification talaga, demonization ng dissent, ng protest, ng organization ng mga youth and students ang ginagawa. Is the DILG Secretary Anyo saying that creating fake accounts, that coordinated inauthentic behavior is part of government policy? No, kasi hindi katanggap-tanggap yan, no, na pinapabayaan natin at tinotolerate natin ang paggamit ng mga fake accounts, no, na gumagawa din ng mga peking conversation at mga simulated, contrived na engagement sa social media.
Now, was there anything concrete that came out of the fact that you guys decided to confront, for example, Director General Monte Agudo regarding the posts that that he had been sharing? I mean, this is in the context of budget deliberations, or usually you can't confront these public officials regarding how public money is being spent because they are public officials. But afterward, was there anything concrete? Was there any commitment at all to somehow temper the post being shared, or somehow to think more wisely before sharing them?
Now we're getting more and more responses, no, that people are now more circumspect when it comes to sharing information on social media. Lagi na nagtatanong, totoo ba talaga to? O nag-check na agad sa amin, no, kung talagang sinabi namin ng isang bagay o ginawa pa namin ito. So, isa yun, no? Marami pang kailangan gawin pagdating sa information and education tungkol sa disinformation at kung paano ito nakaka-apekto sa boses ng bawat isang Pilipino, sa demokrasya, sa Pilipinas. At pangalawa, no, may commitment din ang Committee on Appropriations na pag-aaralan yung pagdadagdag ng special provision sa General Appropriations Bill tungkol sa mga confidential and intelligence expenses. Ang isa sa paulit-ulit namin na nakikita no, mula sa NICA, sa NSC, sa DILG, at sa DND no, kagabi lang, ay hindi ma-identify saan ba talaga nang gagaling na item yung mga ginagamit para sa social media pages na ito. So we must continue no, to demand no, the takedown of others' fake posts, demand responsibility and accountability from all the officers involved. And on the part of this youth representation, an apology is imperative.
Okay, and for the record, by the way, we also invited Interior Secretary Eduardo Año and Director General Monte Agudo to this interview, but unfortunately, they were not available. Well, thank you very much, Congresswoman Ilago, for joining us this morning.
Thank you for having me. Good morning, Mr.